Hey there, welcome back. If you're just joining us, this is acrylic painting with me, Julie E. And I'm just going to use up some leftover paints. They are some This Little Piggy Pigments that I used Liquitex Gloss Varnish as a wetting agent to wet and then mix them into my mix. I will have a mixing tutorial on how they were mixed at the end of this video. Yeah, till then, let's just get to painting, okay? And I'll go over the colors and everything as we use them. As I said, we're using mix. And let's see. I have this heart already prepped and everything for the other night when I was on Artapalooza on Wednesday, and I never got around to using it. I was too busy joking around, having too much fun. Can you really have too much fun, though? I don't think so. So here is the Artist Loft Flow White mixed with mix. Most of these are mixed. One to two parts paint to about seven parts mix. So if you've got 7 ounces of mix, you put 1 to 2 ounces of paint in, depending upon how translucent, how transparent you want it. Mix is awesome. All right, so let's put down, I think I want to do kind of a bloom blowout. So let's go ahead and do that. So I'm going to put down a little bit of a pillow there first. Let's see. I love the s'mores. This is This Little Piggy S'mores. Yeah, I love that one. Let's give it a little bit of a curve, huh? Yeah. Almost looks like, I don't know if you can see that. Let me bring it up. Can you see that halo kind of glowing around there? That halo looks a lot like the halo you get when you do a cloud pearl pour. So this will be interesting. I've never had a cloud effect happen using mix. And my piggies must be very heavy in pigments because they look like they're sinking. Okay, then this beautiful pink. It's a kind of a coral pink. It's very gorgeous, or a salmon pink. It's called sockeye, which is a salmon, so. Hence the name and the color, Julie. Jeez, put two and two together, woman, right? There we go. Like I said, I have a mixing video on how I mix the pigments for this pour coming at the end. There we go. Now, these have sat for a few days. Let's go with This Little Piggy Harvest Gold. That one is gorgeous as well. If you like Sargent Art Liquid Metal paints, and you like their Aztec Gold, you are going to love the Harvest Gold. This little piggy. Really, really beautiful. This one is a combination of Golden Flute Acrylics in Turquoise Phthalo, and then I think I put a little bit of the Soho Lagoon in it to kind of thicken it up because it got really pretty runny. And I wanted them to get to be pretty much the same consistency as the piggies. I'm just going to put this on the outside of each because we're going to be using the blow dryer. So hopefully when we blow our line, it'll blow the piggies across the top of this gorgeous color. I'm hoping. Nothing's ever set in stone when it comes to pouring. So I've got the science down. This one is Arteza Sea Green. It's a really pretty color. And I'm using that because I did not have sea glass mixed up by This Little Piggy. It's almost as pretty as sea glass, but I really... I'm getting an obsession. There's an obsession forming with the sea glass, I gotta tell you. Okay, I love this more as I want more depth. Let me put more in there. Since most of it sank, maybe we can keep some on top. Now that we've got some others left laying down there. There we go. All right. Okay, that should do it. And our cell activator is Amsterdam Titanium White, and I am using Australian Floetrol. I know, shocker, right? I try to never use Australian Floetrol just because it's usually too expensive and out of reach for a lot of people. And because I know when I first started pouring and I first saw the price of that, I was like, oh, holy, no way. But yeah, curiosity got the best of me, and I bought some, and it was like, oh. And I actually did a side-by-side test. If you go back through my videos, you'll see a Aussie Floetrol versus School Glue video where I compared them side-by-side, and wow, was I shocked. Super shocked at how similar they are. And yeah, if I were to pull that board out and not see any of the lettering at the top of the board and stuff, I probably wouldn't know which side was Elmer's School Glue and which side was Aussie Floetrol. Okay, let's get ready. Plug your ears. Here we go. Wand's at the ready. The little bird of mini. Got it strapped down, my cool button strapped down with a little zip tie, always holds it on cool. Gotta credit Christina Welch with that great tip. Works wonderful. All right, gonna put it on high, or maybe, no, you know what? I'm gonna put it on low this time. I'm gonna start it on low and we'll try and blow it out carefully. Here we go. And I wonked them all up. Man. Okay. My girlfriend Janice keeps telling me, find your patience, girl. Find your patience. I'm still looking for it. And I'm gonna try to find my patience on this one. So I'll leave you on time lapse. I'm gonna go check on something. We'll come back. See what's happened with it, because right now I'm like, yeah. Yeah. I mean, I got some cool effects going, but yeah, that, I spin it, that's what's going to be left, that's going to look new. New, new, new. Don't like it. So, okay. Try and find my patience. Okay, we're back. This is the something else I had to go check on. See if there were any Samoas left. Oh, and I got a piece of toasted coconut in my painting. Oh, joy. Yeah, I got it out. Cool. I charge extra for that. Totally forgot to turn this camera on. Yeah, I'm losing my mind today. Okay, I'm back. There is something kind of pretty about that, but the gold is totally lost.
Yeah, the gold is totally lost. The s'mores showed up, but none of my gold is popping up. Things that make you go, Okay, I don't know what to do. Don't know what I want to do. Okay, somebody asked me, and I noticed it in the chat later, but during Artapalooza, and I'm sorry the question never got asked aloud for me to reply, the reason that I take all my paint and save it, basically between every spin, is because I would rather save all this paint in a cup and reuse it than waste it. But also because the more paint that I get off of my spinner before I spin, the less flies off and all around for me to have to clean up during during my painting and stuff. So yeah, I don't like having to wipe down every single bottle and torch and wall, possibly carpet, because paint went flying off my table and onto everything else. So that is why I do this. But also, it helps if I see a side that's not having paint on it in a certain spot, I can grab some from that area. It's usually pretty close to the same color match and pattern as what should be in that area that the paint missed on that canvas. See, like right here, right in here, you see it's green and white. So I pick that up and I can pour a tilt and let it run down. And that way my canvas is covered, but I'm not worried about my sides right now because I'm not really liking this. I'm really not. And I think I'm gonna re-pour. So I'm just collecting all the paint now that I can. Hopefully without tearing my aluminum foil that's underneath. But yeah, I will save all this in a cup. Woo! Just like this soggy one. And then, trusty popsicle stick. And then what I will do is I will mix it all up like this and see what kind of color we get. And then I will probably use that as a base coat on another pour. And because it's got all those little piggy pigments in it and everything, it'll probably be all pretty and shimmery. So you don't really have to add a pearl medium to it. So yeah, I'll put that through a strainer. So in case there's any little chunky monkeys in there floating around. But yeah, see how pretty a kind of a pale green that is? It's really pretty. It looks almost like Arteza pearl pistachio. Just beautiful. And all that would have been wasted if I would have just spun and let it hit the sides of a container or all down here on my table mat. So that is why you will see me constantly scraping all the paint up from around my canvas. All right, I'm gonna give it a little baby spin, see if it makes any difference, see if there's any changes. Let me give it another torch, see if any colors pop up besides what we've got. Yeah, I flubbed with the hairdryer when I switched it over to high, and all the metal cells got all weird and wonky on me, so that was my bad. Huh. Yeah. It's really not what I was going for. Not a fan of it. Not a fan of it at all. All right. Let's put down a little bit more white. Okay, I'm going to start out with the lagoon first. Or not lagoon. Golden. Golden turquoise phthalo mixed with lagoon. Sorry about that. Alright, then I'm going to put the Arteza pearl sea green down. There we go. Then I'm going to go in with the s'mores. Lay that down, and holy cow, does my mother-in-law have the TV turned up. My goodness. And she knows I'm up here. Bless her heart. Okay. Then we're going to go with the gold. There we go. And let's go with the sockeye. Here we are. Let it drift that way a little bit. Okay, and try it again. Try it again, try it again. At first you don't succeed, try again, right? All right, it's probably way too much cell activator, but too late to do anything now. All right, I'm going on high from jump. Oh, let me torch it. There we go. There. All right. And wands at the ready. Here we go. Wow, no lacing at all. What the heck? What the heck was that? She asks, bewildered. It totally laced the first one. Ah. All right, gonna let it sit. Gonna let it sit and percolate and do its thing. And we will come back. See what happens. Wow. That is pretty though, even though it didn't lace. I really love that movement. So pretty. I don't want to destroy it. I didn't get the lacing or anything that I was hoping for the bloom lacing type effects, even with the Australian Floetrol. Like I said, for some reason it's been hit and miss with me for a little while since we started the move. It's a And hopefully Julie will get her groove back here. We'll see. Yeah, I think I want to leave this one. So I'm going to set this one aside because, yeah, there's just something about it I really love. And I want to keep it.
So, okay, so here's our cups. All right, in there. Let me measure it out so I can tell you exactly how much I'm putting in there. Okay, get my scale. Let's go to grams. Okay, all right. Now, I'm gonna pour some of this in. Just enough to wet the bottom of the cup. There we go. Okay, and that is 8 grams. Oop, wrong cup, wrong cap. Blah, blah, blah. Okay, so I've got eight grams in there. Okay, zero that out, and zero it out, and this is going to be sockeye. Get my stick. All of your micas are going to be different weights. That's why it looks like there's different amounts in your jars. When you get some jars, they're going to be full to the top. When you get other jars, they might just be half full. But there is still the same weight of micas in each jar. So, yeah. So what we're doing is kind of going more by volume than we are by weight. And my guess is that would be a teaspoon. So 1 teaspoon. I don't have measuring spoons up here, I'm sorry. I suppose I should get a set just for these so it's easier to explain it to you. Okay, and there would be our second. All right. Tap off my extra. So, and my notifications are going off. Sorry about that, guys. Okay, that is quite liquidy. It just runs off like water this time. 8 grams. All right, clear that. Clear it. And I've got some mix already here in this cup. And a quick tip, always leave your stick in the cup and zero it out because your stick adds weight. There's weight to your stick. So if you leave it in your cup and zero it out as you're adding your pouring medium, you'll get a more accurate reading of your pouring medium. Okay, there's 1 to 1. Okay, 16. Okay, 16, 24 would be 3 to 1. Okay, there we go. So we've got 24 grams of mix. 24 grams of mix to 8 grams. Of pigments. That is looking really pretty. Okay, so that would be mixed, 3 parts mix, 1 part pigment. Wipe that off of there. Okay. Let's go ahead and go up to 32. Let's go 4 parts. A little bit more, but that's okay. It's only 2 grams more. Hopefully it won't matter. So yeah, 4 parts. There we go. Okay. that looks really good, and I'm going to leave it right there. So yeah, 4-1 on the mix.
We're back with dry results already. Here it is, my mistake. I figured out what I had done wrong as far as my cell activator went, and why I wasn't getting the lacing and everything, and why I ended up with this really kind of cool cloud effect, is because I used a little cup full of base paint that was sitting in my tub that I was using on tiles the night before. And so, yeah, I had the Artist Loft Soft Body White mixed up with mix in a small cup. And didn't realize I'd grabbed that instead of the other different looking Dixie cup that was my Titanium White Nazi Floetrol. So, yeah, scatterbrain. Need to pay attention to what I'm doing, but look at that. Isn't that gorgeous? Just beautiful. I love the colors and everything. It looks blurry and fuzzy and foggy and cloudy, and it's just gorgeous. And then, yeah, look at that. How shiny and bright and beautiful is that? I love that harvest gold. Love the harvest gold. But yeah, that sockeye is really, really catching my fancy too. Because I love how dark it gets and purplish it gets over darker colors, and then how light pink it gets over light colors and stuff. It's just so pretty, the variations of colors you can get with it. But yeah, there it is in all its glory. So until next time, guys, have a great week. Loves and hugs, y'all. Bye.